Assalamu alaikum, everybody welcome. Everybody is welcome. CR.
Yes, sir.
Okay. CR, it was just Hamza kar raha hai na?
No. Yes, sir.
Okay. Dusra, have you shared the email that was sent to CR section C?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now you might have everybody listen it carefully, and also it is required that you should keep class notes registered with you, because everything that will not be written in the that may not be available in the lab report. So additional information, those should be reproduced according to your own way, so that whenever you are getting prepared for the viva or the quiz, you must be having the class notes with you. It will be helping a lot. So first of all, first we start with the new job, that is to the determination of the compressive strength of hydraulic cement mortar. First of all, there will be significance, and it will be addressed according to ASTM C109. As you know, first of all, that cement mortar, it means that there will be cement, along with that there will be the sand, and it makes when you will be adding the water, it will make a slurry or a plastic material which is known as mortar, Now, why we are interested in finding out the compressive strength of the hydraulic cement? Hydraulic means you are adding the water. This is hydraulic. So why we are interested in finding out the compressive strength? You know that the mortar or the concrete that is weak in tension, and wherever this will be put under tension, over there we will be providing the reinforcing bars. So concrete with the reinforcement, that is generally known, that is known as reinforced concrete. See, here awaaz aa rahi hai, samajh bhi aa rahi hai?
Yes, sir.
Uzair hai aap? Uzair?
Yes, sir.
Whenever anybody is facing any confusion, he can point it out without any hesitation. This is your duty. Instead of wasting the time, everybody is required to raise the question. If he or she is facing any difficulty in understanding. So as you know, that the mortar or the concrete that is weak in tension, so we will be using the reinforcing bars. So such sort of structure will be known as reinforced concrete, RCC. However, the mortar or the concrete that is strong enough in compression, so we are interested in finding out the compressive strength. This is one thing. Secondly, in general, the mortar, this is used for the brickwork. Normally, this is used for the brick or plastering. Now, in the brickwork, the mortar will be placed on B, and there will be the load which is coming from the upper level to the lower level, and the mortar will be in compression between the brickwork, between the different entities of the brickwork. So it is very important to find out the compressive strength of the cement mortars. And if you are using more water cement ratio, then certainly it will not be strong enough to take the compressive load. So you will have to finalize a proper cement sand ratio. You will have to manage a mortar that can take the load effectively in compression. So this is the significance of this test. This is the significance of the test. It should also be reproduced on your class notes register. Now we will be following ESTM standard 109, and accordingly we will be whatsoever parameters have been established by ASTM, those will be followed, and we will be finding out accordingly the compressive strength of the cement mortar. So it should be remembered, once again I'm repeating it, that the compressive strength significance of this test is that the mortar is generally used for the brickwork, and between the courses of the bricks we will be pouring the mortar, and certainly the compressive load will come onto the layers of the mortar. So if it is, it can withstand the compressive load, then that brickwork will be strong enough. So this is necessary. So following covers only that portion which is required to determine the compressive strength of 2-inch or 50 millimeter mortar tubes. So in this case we will be producing only 2-inch or 50 millimeter square mortar tubes, and those will be tested, and the process of mixing the and the preparing the mortar, that is very similar to the previous one, that there will be a pond of the cement and sand, then you will be pouring the water in that, and then you will be properly mixing and thoroughly mixing the cement that will take place. And it should complete within almost two minutes, and then after that you will fill the molds in two layers, and then it will be left in place for 24 hours, and after that you will take it out and from the mold, and then it will be placed for the curing, and then you will test it. Now the procedure, so this is the significance that why we are performing the compressive strength on the mortar cubes. So you can also write over here, mortars. Now there will be a scale weighing balance, okay, that can take the load that can weigh about 2 kg minimum. Then there will be 2-inch cube molds, rubber temples, trowel, then 500 grams of the pondered cement. Basically it is you can take even 300 grams, but as far the ESTM standard is concerned, you are required to take the 500 grams. Similarly, 1375 grams of the Ottawa sand. What is Ottawa? Ottawa basically, this is because they have standardized this procedure, so they are having the right to establish criteria from their own end. So this is Ottawa. Ottawa is a specific sand which is having some certain soils, some specific proportion of the different sizes of the particles. But this is given over there. If you can write, put hours in, please write it down, everybody. 2 hours sand is a standard sand which is equivalent to 2 hours sand and the particles are almost, the particles of the sand are almost entirely naturally rounded grains of nearly pure quartz. Quartz with 30% of sand with 30% of sand passing through sieve number 30 bracket 600 microns and retained on sieve number 40 and retained on sieve number 40 will start 45% 45% percentage passing between 40 and 50, sieve number 40 and 50, and 25% between 50 and 100, sieve number 50 and 100. Now, the sand with this gradation, is it clear to every person? Is it clear there? Any other person? So, if the gradation or the percentage passing is 30% between 30-40, then 45 between sieve number 40 and 50. And 25% between 50 and 100, then it is considered equivalent to the Ottawa sand. Now this is this has been facilitated by this is the facility which is available if we are to consider, because we are having our own so the sand with our own source. So that cannot be certainly replaced by their gradation that can be used. So this is the specific gradation that must be kept in mind if we are interested in establishing the standard sand equivalent to that of Ottawa. Okay, it should be noted. So 1375 grams of Ottawa sand with that same gradation that I have told you, then this will be 242 cc milliliter of water, and this comes out to be water cement ratio equivalent to 0.484. Cement ratio point, that is equivalent to, that is equal to 0.484. So this is in accordance with the STM standard. What will be the procedure that will be adopted? First of all is the mixing. After that, this is the preparation of the mortar. Then is the molding the test specimen. Now in this case, weigh 300 grams of the cement and prepare the corresponding weights of the standard sand and water. Place the dry pattern. Now this is, you can see, this is very similar to the mixer that you might have seen in the geotech lab over there. This is very similar to the milk shaker. There is a bowl, and that is equipped with a paddle that rotates within that bowl. You will be placing the cement and sand, and then you will start moving the dry paddle for the mixing process. Then introduce the material for batch into the bowl and mix up in the following manner. So all the mixing water in the bowl, add the cement and mix at low speed for 30 seconds. Add the entire quantity of sand within 30 seconds and mix it at slow speed. Then stop the mixer, change the medium speed and mix for 30 seconds and stop the mixer. Let the mortar stay for 1.5 minutes. During the first 15 seconds of disinterval, quickly scrape down into the batch any mortar that have been collected on the side of the bowl. So after these two modes of mixing, you will just scrape the material that might have stuck to the inner wall of the bowl, and then finish by mixing it for 1 minute at medium speed. So basically, if that is not available with you, if the mixer is not available with you, then it will be carried out manually. It will be carried out manually, and the mixing process must be carried out thoroughly. It should be carried out thoroughly. So it must be noted that the strength and the property of the mortar or the concrete, that will be depending upon thorough mixing of the ingredients. If you are not mixing the ingredients thoroughly, then you will not be able to get the required properties from the mix. So this is to be done when you are preparing the mortar. Misala jo aapne banana hai, uske liye ye procedure. However, this is in accordance with the ASTM standard, but in the lab, certainly we are not having the, you may or may not be having the bowl. The basic purpose, basic requirement is just to have proper thorough mixing of the ingredients of the mortar or even the cube. Okay? So this can also be done manually. So once you have prepared the mortar, then you will be preparing the test specimens. And these will be prepared in the molds. And molds are, those are in the form of a continuous blocks, you can see. Okay, and in one block, different blocks, the combined block, this is the bigger, larger block. This is consisting of 8 small blocks. What will you do? You will be just this material that you have produced, it will be placed in 2 layers. All the blocks will be filled in 2 layers, in first layer. And before pouring this mortar, you will apply the oil inside. You will apply a thin film of the oil so that the cement mortar should not stuck to the walls of the mold. And then you will be filling all these blocks. So for the half layer will be filled. And after that, you will temper. You will try to mix the mortar properly, and you will try to apply a force for compaction, and this force of compaction should be very small. Okay, so you will be placing the layer half of the depth of the mold, then temp the mortar in each cube 32 times. What does it mean? It means you will be preparing, this is one body, one block, which is consisting of 8. then you will be using another block which is also available, and so it you can see that the mode of filling that will be, first of all, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then you reverse it. Okay, so it will be replaced with this one, this will be with this one. So it's you will be preparing the this number of fill karna padega. So 10 each to 32 times. So about 4 rounds, each round will be at right angle to the other one. The tamping pressure just sufficient to ensure uniform filling of the mold. So you will not be applying more pressure. Simple, it should be just sufficient to fill the mold. The 4 rounds of the tamping shall be completed in 1 cube before going to the next. So just you will cut off the mortar, the protruding material jo bahar nikal raha hoga, that will be cut off, take it, and you will level it. Now these molds are to be kept for 24 hours in the moist room, and then open them and keep the specimens in water for a week. This is for the curing purpose. So this is the procedure for preparing the test specimens. Is it okay, everybody? There?
Yes, sir.
Anyone from the class? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Shabash.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, take care. So after seven days, we'll take the specimen, dry it with a clean cloth, and if you are not having any clean cloth, just it should be kept for 2 or 3 hours in open air. If you are not having any cloth, just keep it in air, or even you can it can be put under the fan. All these specimens can be put under the fan, and then the surface will get dry, and now these are ready for testing. Now the cubes must be put in on one side using extra steel plate, star loading 1.4 kilonewton per second in a minute. When failure takes place, record the load and it will be the and calculate the compressor strength. So this is the procedure, very simple. Very simple procedure is there. So you, as far as this cement sand ratio is concerned, this is cement sand ratio is 1:2.75. This is the ratio for cement sand as per the ESDN standard. It should also be noted. It should be written over here. Now, in this case, it should also be noted that you are to prepare the mortar. When you are using this mortar for the brickwork, it will stay for the whole life of the brickwork. Okay? This mortar will stay in its place for the whole life of the structure. So you can, and the minimum time which is required for finding out the compressive strength of the cube, that is for the concrete, that is 28 days. So you can test the mortar or the cubes for 3 days, for 7 days, for 28 days. Okay, so as per ESDM standard, you will be testing it after 7 days. You will test it for after 7 days. Okay, so we will be testing it for 7 days. However, also have the test. You can also have the specimen to be tested for 3 days and for 28 days. However, it has been given, it has been stated by ASTM standard that 7 days, this is the sufficient duration for finding out the compressive strength of the mortar cubes. So you will record the load using UTM, universal testing machine, or the any compression testing machine, and you will be preparing the observations and calculations, type of cement, source, manufacturer, sampling person. So first of all, you will note the load that will be taken up by the specimens, okay? And from one batch, this is one batch, this is second batch. Similarly, there will be at least four batches. So you will take the average of all these. You can take the average. So you will be writing the load over there. Then this one. So up char, yeah, isi tarike se, you can also prepare further blocks, yeah, batches for the preparation of the mortar cubes, and you can test it. Then this will be the load. It will be divided by the area. What will be the area? Area is 50 by 50 millimeter. Okay, 2500 millimeter square. So you will be dividing this load by 2500 millimeter square. Then you will be getting the. It will be converted into the Newton, and that will, so accordingly you can find out the megapascal. Also, it can be stated in PSI as well. You know that this is 2 by 2 inch cube. So whatsoever the load will be taken up by the specimen, that will be divided by the surface area, and you will be finding out the compressive strength of the concrete mortar. So this is the way you will be finding out the compressive strength of the cement cube, mortar cube. G. Also, you can also it should also be noted that this strength can also be the same procedure that can be taken, that can be used for finding out the compressive strength of the concrete, but the size will be different. But the size of the sample, that will be different, that will be 6 by 6 inch cube. And there will certainly, the basic requirement for the preparation of the sample, that is thorough mixing of the material. So it is almost complete today's job. If you are having any confusion, or if there is any question that can be raised, please, everybody. Yes. And the Ayan.
Yes, sir.
Shabash. 56.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fariha.
Yes, sir.
Shabash. Sarfaraz. Sir Faraz.
Yes, sir.
Shabash. Shazib.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, G. So, any question, please? Any question? Acha ji. along with this one, you might have been shared with the different one or two videos, which have been equipped with the detail given in ASTM standard for initial and final setting time, and also initial and final setting time, standard consistency of the cement paste. So if you are having any query or confusion, that can also be shared, please. अगर किसी को कोई मसला हो उसमें तो वो डिटेल जो है वो आपको दी हुई है, जो बेस्ट सूटेबल जो वीडियो थी वो मैंने आपके साथ शेयर की, मुनासिब जो है वो इसमें इफ आई रिमेंबर आई टोल्ड यू दैट द टाइम फॉर द इनिशियल सेटिंग दैट इज जनरली टेकन टू बी 45 मिनट्स, इट शुड नॉट बी लेस देन 45 मिनट्स, ठीक है, इनिशियल सेटिंग. तो ये similarly or 10 hours hai, and there is a theoretical approach for the for finding out the final setting time. So there may be, if you are following the different codes of practices by different agencies, ASTM, British standard, or any other standard, then there may be little bit difference, but the procedure, it should be remembered, the procedure for the for finding out the standard consistency procedure, similarly for finding out initial and final setting time, that will remain same. There is no difference in the approach for finding out all these parameters. However, the criteria or the code, that may be a little bit giving you different reference values. Those may be giving you different reference values. It should be noted. So you need not to worry about that one, that this video is saying that it should vary from 30 to 45 minutes or 1 hour, yeah, whatsoever is the case. So you need not to worry, but according to ASTM, it is 45 minutes. And generally, this in general, this may vary. So whatsoever, now at this time, it should be remembered, whatsoever is the initial setting time, it should be noted, and accordingly you need to perform the test as well as prepare the mix design at site according to the same information. You need to prepare the concrete at site. Ji. Anyone from the class, everybody is welcome. Zunera. You are not available?
Yes, sir.
ये क्या अचानक आप जो है ना ज्वाइन कर लिया, पहले आप किधर थे? अच्छा चले, ये आप बताएं कि कोई आपको कोई कंफ्यूजन, कोई ambiguity or any question?
No, sir, no.
I can understand. Chale, Bilal Mirza.
Yes, sir.
Beta, koi discussion, koi
swap. Sir, filhal to nahi hai, ek dafa revise karenge to for next time.
Yeah, ho jana chahiye. To chale, okay, Uzair, aap ye iski attendance le le. Uzair. छोड़ ले लें और फिर रिकॉर्डिंग भी जो है ना वो आप मुझे जी. उज़ैर
यस सर,
हो गया जी. सो वी विल मीट नेक्स्ट टाइम इंशाल्लाह.